welcome to Breathe Kids Church. Shout at your screen if you are ready to have the best morning ever. We are too. If you are new this morning, my name is Lucy. Thank you again so much for joining us. We're looking forward to spending our Sunday morning with you. After three, I want you to shout your names as loud as you possibly can at your screen so we know who is here watching with us. Ready? One, two, three. Awesome, so many of you, I could definitely hear you from here. Let's have a look how you got on with the challenge.
That's actually amazing.
Not bad.
To start off our morning, I'm going to hand over to Sam and Bing, who are going to race to see who can make the tallest tower using household objects.
We're building a tower out of household items.
Start with that one.
Toppled out. Ready, Bronte? And you, Sam, go and kick it. Right there, Bink. Hey!
That was awesome. Who thinks they can have a race building the tallest tower with household objects with the people from your house? If you think you can do even better than what Sam and Bink did, ask your grown-ups to send in a video of you doing this challenge so that we can show all of your friends here next week. We are now going to go into a time of praise and worship. Yes, it's my favourite time of the morning, and I hope it's one of your favourite times too. Let's go and praise Jesus together.
nothing will ever change that. You will always be forever you and me. Jesus, you are my best friend. And you will always be. And nothing will ever change that. Jesus, you are my best friend. And you will always be.
Was amazing. I have my best dancing feet out and my best singing voice to praise Jesus. I hope you did too. Now last week we looked at part 2 of day 6 of creation. I am actually in awe of how amazing God is and how he created us in his own image. So today we're going to look at day 7, the last day of creation. But first let's take a look at the video together.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was empty, formless, and dark. But the Spirit of God was there. On the first day, God said, "Let there be light." And God saw that the light was good. Then he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day and the darkness night. On the second day, God said, "Let there be a space to separate the waters of the heavens from the waters of the earth." God called the space sky. On the third day, God said, "Let the waters beneath the sky flow together into one place, so dry ground may appear." God called the dry ground land and the waters seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the land sprout with every sort of plant and tree." And God saw that it was good. On the fourth day, God said, "Let lights appear in the sky to separate the day from the night." God made two great lights, the sun for the day and the moon for the night. He also made the stars. God set these lights in the sky to light the earth, and God saw that it was good. On the fifth day, God said, "Let the waters swarm with fish and other life. Let the skies be filled with birds of every kind." And God saw that it was good. On the sixth day, God said, "Let the earth make every sort of animal." God made all sorts of wild animals, livestock and small animals, each able to have babies of the same kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, to be like us." So God created man in his own image. He formed man from the dust of the ground. He breathed the breath of life into man, and a man became alive. Then he saw that the man needed a helper, so God put man into a deep sleep, and while he slept, God took one of the man's ribs. Then God made a woman from the rib and brought her to the man.
Hello.
Hi.
Then God blessed them and said, "Be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and rule over it. Rule over the fish in the sea."
Hello.
The birds in the sky.
Hello, bird.
And all the animals that scurry along the ground. Then God said, "Look, I have given you every plant throughout the earth and all the fruit trees for your food. And I have given you every green plant as food for all the animals." Then God looked over all he had made and he saw that it was very good. So the creation of the heavens and the earth and everything in them was done. So on the seventh day, God rested from all his work. And God blessed the seventh day and said it was holy.
loved every second of that creation story. I don't know about you, but it's definitely one of my favourites. So today, let's look at day 7 of creation. God rested. Now, it's time for you to go and get your notebook, a pen, and a Bible. You have 10 seconds. Go! You were so fast at getting your notebook, pens, and Bibles. Super impressed. So, if you have your Bible with you, turn with me to Genesis chapter 2, verses 1 to 3, and we'll read it together. It says this. So the sky, the earth, and all that filled them were finished. By the seventh day, God finished the work he had been doing. So on the seventh day, he rested from all his work. God blessed the seventh day and made it a holy day. He made it holy because on that day, he rested. He rested from all the work he had done in creating the world. So it actually only took God 6 days to create the world and everything in it. That's less than a week. None of us could get that much completed. Well, I know, I definitely couldn't. Anyway. So on the seventh day, God rested from all the work he had done. God did a lot of work, and so he rested. God shows us that it's okay to have a rest. Some people might think that we have to keep going all the time. But that isn't biblical, it doesn't say that in the Bible. God actually tells us to rest. God rested, which means it's okay for us to rest too. And God blessed the seventh day and made it holy. That's why we're supposed to rest on one day a week and keep it holy. This day normally would be on a Sunday where we gather together for church. That includes church online, just like we're doing right now. So after he created everything, he rested from all the work he had done. I think he deserves it, don't you? So our last recap. Day 1 of creation, God said, let there be light. On day 2 of creation, God said, let there be space between the waters of the heavens and the waters of the earth. On day 3, God said, let the waters beneath the sky flow together into one place so that dry ground may appear. Let the earth produce plants. On the fourth day, God said, let lights appear in the sky to separate the day from the night. And on the fifth day, God said, let the waters swarm with fish and other life. Let the skies be filled with birds of every kind. On the sixth day, God said, let the earth produce every sort of animal and let us make human beings in our image to be like us. And finally, on day 7, God rested. I have had the most amazing time having a look at the story of creation with you. How awesome that God created the whole world in 6 days. And on the final day, day 7, he had a rest. And he looked at his amazing creation. You know, we can go outside and look at the trees and think, wow, God created that tree. God created me and God created you. Every day we can be thankful to God for his amazing creation. Thank you so much for sending in your memory verse videos. I'm finding it so encouraging and amazing that you are going away and reading your Bible and remembering God's word. Let's take a look at how you got on with last week's memory verse.
I say this because I know what I have planned for you, says the Lord. I have good plans for you.
I don't plan to hurt you. I plan to give you a hope and a good future. Jeremiah 29, verse 11.
This week you have got a brand new memory verse. Once you have learned it, you can ask your grown-up to send it to the Breathe Kids Church Dropbox so we can see how you got on with it next week. Are you up for that challenge? That sounds like there is a lot of you, so I'm expecting to see many people reading the word and memorising it this week. So this week, our memory verse is Proverbs 3 verse 5. It says this, trust the Lord with all your heart, don't depend on your own understanding. Say it with me, Proverbs 3 verse 5. Trust the Lord with all your heart, don't depend on your own understanding. Remember to go and underline that in your Bibles, write it down so that you can remember the Word of God. Let's take a look now at how you got on with the craft from last week. I'm now going to hand over to Naomi, who has got another awesome craft for you to do with your families this week.
Hello and welcome to day 7 of creation, and this is where God rested. So what we've decided to do is to build like a tent bed fort thing. So basically what you need to do is get every soft furnishing that you can get your hands on and that your parents are quite happy with you making your fort out of. That in our house is pretty much everything. So once you've assembled that, you need to decide where you're going to have your fort, and again it needs to be somewhere quite sensible where you're not in the way. Okay, so far you can see we have an absolute mountain of soft furnishings which Ben is trying out for us. You need to watch your head behind you, Ben. So Ben's got all cushions, he's got duvets, he's got a shark bean bag, which is very exciting. And then we're going to assemble this. This is in the room at the back of the house. We've also got a clothes area, which is really good for putting blankets on and things like that, giving a bit of height to your structure. And then we've got buckets of toys, we've got a coffee table, and we've got a sofa that we're just going to drape our blankets over and generally make an amazing tent fort. So we're going to get back to you to show you what it looks like in a moment.
Yep.
So first of all, we are selecting the different blankets. Lizzie's going to put cushions down on the floor as well so that she's got a comfortable place to lie around in and rest, because that's what day 7's all about. Ooh. Ben's getting carried away just resting already. You need to make it first, Ben.
Yeah. As you carry on, you might find all the little gaps with smaller blankets.
Excellent tips there from Lizzie, the professional tent maker. How many years experience, Lizzie, do you have of building tents, would you say?
Since
you were a baby, that's 11 years of tent building experience. That's quite impressive. Excellent. Already we can see that the tent is taking shape.
Right.
Lizzie's wrestling with some pillows.
Yeah.
It's a workout as well, isn't it?
It is, yes.
Just have a look inside, see how things are. Oh yes, that's impressive. Lizzie's just nearly knocked herself out.
I'm okay.
So now you can see exactly how far we've got with this. So we've basically covered the frame with every blanket that we've ever owned in our entire life. Ben, do you want to show us inside?
Yes.
Go on, oh, go on then, you take it. Oh. That's inside.
So here we have day 7 of creation, the day of rest. I think it's my favourite day, to be honest with you.
That looks so good. I wonder if any of you can go away and make one of those today with your families. Once you've made it, remember, get your grown-ups to send in a picture of you so that we can show all of your friends on this video next week how awesome your creations are. We have got a brand new devotional for you this week, all about day 7 of creation. You can find that on the Breathe New Life Church website following the link in this post. We hope you're encouraged by them and we hope that you're enjoying them. I have loved exploring creation with you. I'm even more amazed at God. I don't know about you. Next week we're going to look at Adam and Eve. So if you want to find out and learn about Adam and Eve, join us again next week for Breathe Kids Church, 9 o'clock here on Church Online. Remember, if you want to be a part of the video, ask your grown-ups to send in a photo of you or a video of you doing the craft, the challenge or the memory verse. We love watching and looking at what you have got on with throughout the week, and we love putting them in this video so that we can show everybody else how awesome you are. We have had another amazing morning with you. Thank you so much for joining us. We hope that you're going to join us again next week to hear all about Adam and Eve. Have the best week. See you all very soon.